practically live from an underground bunker below Capital City at Cyber Nations Quarterly, bringing you the news once a week, every day. I'm Sir Paul with the Wartime Edition. And now, here's the news. As many of you know, the world is currently embroiled in a terrible world war. To find out why I'm currently in a bunker, we must review the timeline of the events that led to this war. The story begins with the United Nations. Several months ago, a loser brought information to Vladimir of the New Pacific Order. Vlad accepted the intel and asked how this access was achieved, promising to set up a special forum for the spy. The correspondent stopped, the forum was never set up, and this was forgotten about until the loser NPO member in question gave the private messages between Vlad and himself to the Lou, who broke off diplomatic relations and cancelled the non-aggression pact on July 11th. The same day, Mu Cao with Guns, NPO war counselor, then started a thread called Alert Status 1. This does not mean DEFCON 1. The thread essentially stated that the NPO nations should start preparing for a possible combat in the next few days. Dilber, Ivan, and Vladimir apologized for the incident, and Vlad promised that his intentions were not malicious, trying to get out a spy. It looked as though the Cyberverse was ready to move on, and the NPO nations were told to stand down Alert Status 1 on July 14th. However, all was not well within the Cyberverse. On the evening of July 15th, just before update, Yardovich, member of the United Nations, posted a series of stories that were highly obscene, featuring prominently Rhizonia and Pius XIII. The story was so obscene that we cannot republish it as it would violate the terms of service for both YouTube and EnvisionFree. It was also possible that the Cyber Nations boards could have been deleted for a term of service violation. Yardovich was promptly banished from the game and Lou started to draft an apology. However, during the draft of the apology, some losers laughed at the story, heckled those calling for an apology, and created signatures for their fallen comrade. Meanwhile, a meeting took place between the leaders of Gato, the ODN, and the New Pacific Order. NPO leaders decided that the OOC attack was so bad that it warranted an icy response, fearful that Goatsies and Luicides would get the boards terminated. Gato leader Yoda said that the mutual defense pact with Lu was over and promised, because of their democratic statues, that they would take 4 days before deciding whether to stay neutral or join in a war against Lu. ODN representatives said that they needed time to decide what to do, but felt that the association with Lu through United for Orange was troubling. Things came to a head at 11 o'clock, when Tigaland, emperor of the new Polar Order, which does have a nuclear first strike policy, launched a nuclear strike against Duffman after he said that they should apologize to everyone but Rhizonia. The proverbial assassination of the Archduke had happened. After a Lu counterattack against new Polar Order nations, New Pacific Order Emperor Ivan Moldavi declared war against Lu at 11:14, as did the IGC, of which Rhizonia is a part of. At 11:15, Anomaly and Seattle became locked in a war, and Anomaly fired the first nuclear weapon into New Pacific Order territory. The War Council then gave the green light for the use of nuclear weapons. So far, 183 nuclear weapons have been used this month. Later that evening, Gato declared war on the New Pacific Order, the New Polar Order, and the IGC. This led to a flurry of anti-NPO activity, creating a coalition of Gato, Lu, the Federation, GGA, SRI, CGS, Angel, ICSN, APA, AOAN, DDA, TAGA, OIN, and LSF. Don't forget Poland! And Poland. So the major powers declaring neutrality are the GPA, the Legion, and the Grey Council. The ODN recently had elections and are awaiting for their conclusion before deciding what to do. However, with nearly all of their members having taken an oath never to raise arms against the Emperor of the New Pacific Order, should they join the coalition, their involvement would probably be limited. Meanwhile, the administration team has released Sound and Fury since the Luicide of Yardovich. Moderation and admin agree that the Lu mask should be permanently removed from the game, and there should be a round of purges. Notable nations such as Vengashi, Tyrol, and several losers have their forum accounts and nations deleted. Many nations and alliances expressed dismay over the seemingly harsh tactics of the administration team, but admin and moderation are standing firm. In the words of admin, peace be upon him, I personally asked moderation to do this. This was my decision. At this point, this is a war of opportunity. Many have said what Yardovich did was reprehensible and that those that laughed should be curb-stomped, but this is the best only chance of taking down NPO imperialism. With Gates reneging on its four-day pledge and the termination of the Lou Mutual Defense Pact and the Legion on the sidelines, many feel that the NPO is vulnerable to attack. Indeed, the LSF is not attacking IGC, but only NPO nations. However, the Coalition for Justice still has more nuclear weapons than the Coalition, and it has more experience with organization and aid chains. So far, it appears that only Gates was able to match the military and financial coordination of the Pacific and War Council and Bank. However, with many nations involved, many nuclear weapons still in play, and global radiation maxed out at 3.0, we are in for a long, hard slog. And now, a word from our sponsor. Since the last edition, things have taken a turn for the worst against the Orders. The Orange Defense Network decided that the wording in the United for Orange Treaty, where an attack on Lou would be seen as an attack on the ODN, required the Orange Defense Network to see that Lou was defended. It was the joining of the Orange Defense Network that led to the nuclear weapons being detonated over Capital City, thus causing delay in the production of this episode. In remembrance of the dreadful attack, Twizzlers are hereby forever banned in Sir Paul. Meanwhile, IGC Empress Raisonia achieved peace with the Coalitions for her battered alliance by apologizing for her actions and resigning as Empress. However, GGA nations broke with the Coalition and refused to grant peace until the remains of the IGC alliance left the green trading sphere. The IGC complied. Raisonia, now a free agent, then joined the New Pacific Order to continue her fight against the Coalition. Later, in a surprise move, the ODN dissolved the United for Orange Treaty, citing the actions of Lou. While the ODN felt compelled to honor the Mutual Defense Pact, they did it out of obligation to their prior commitments. As the bomb drops and tanks attacked, peace was being negotiated behind closed doors. While a tentative agreement was reached between Gato, ODN, and NPO negotiators, leading to a 24-hour ceasefire, the agreed terms were rejected by the NAAC, Lou, and GGA representatives. With the Coalition having many different objectives for the military conflict, it seemed that a comprehensive peace would be difficult to achieve. Then the Covenant of the Lost scandal broke. Several key players in several alliances, including Legion, NPO, ODN, and Gato, were found to be in league with each other to collect all the secrets in the cyberverse. Another 24-hour ceasefire between the principals, minus NAAC and Lou, was called to sort the mess out. However, instead of a lasting peace, a Coven member leaked private NPO council logs in which King Justin and others said that the Legion would pay for their actions, as well as some other unflattering comments. The Legion decided that this was a clear and present danger to their safety and sovereignty, and declared war on the NPO, causing large amounts of damage. In the interim, the NPO had been working on bilateral talks with the ODN and Legion. They left the Coalition and achieved peace with the Orders in exchange for a non-nuclear first strike pact, apologies from Ivan and Tigaland, as well as Taiga's resignation. Electron Sponge is now the new emperor for the new Polar Order. Exion and the Orange Shadow Network followed suit and offered the Orders peace. Currently, the Orders have dropped below 500,000 strength, and the Legion Blitz has secured their dominance in the game. Not only that, a general indefinite ceasefire has been reached between the Coalition and the Orders to work out final terms for peace. Although many GGA and Lou members are upset that the Orders will not be taken down to zero infrastructure, they are complying with the Cease to Hostilities order. Once again, peace reigns. Please turn tape over for Side 2.